गुड आफ्टरनून एवरी वन, आई एम कोपल किरण, स्कूल असिस्टेंट सोशल स्टडीज, वर्किंग एट ZPHS एनलपल्ली सूर्यापेट मंडल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कसिंग अबाउट 9th क्लास सोशल स्टडीज 12th लेसन डेमोक्रेटिक एंड नेशनलिस्ट रेवल्यूशंस इन द 17th 18th एंड 19th सेंचुरीज. In the chapter, end of this chapter, students able to understand these learning outcomes. We can achieve these learning outcomes from the students after this chapter. Let us discuss one by one what are the learning outcomes we can gain it. Students know the French society. Students understand the special privileges. Students analyze the different kinds of taxes. Students understand the French philosophers. Students understand the Bastille Fort broke out. Students observe and interpret the picture in the page number 159. Students locate the French, Prussia, Spain, Portugal, Austria in the world map. These learning outcomes we can achieve after this topic. Look at this world map. Students observe the world map. What do you observe from the world map? Yes, there are some countries highlighted with the color. Look at this is America, Britain, France. We have discussed already glorious revolution in England 1688 and also the war of American independence 1783. These 17th century and 18th century revolutions we were discussed in the previous classes. In this class we will discuss French Revolution. Look at this picture carefully and observe the French continent, French nation. First in 1774, C means common era. Louis XVI became the king of France. He came to the throne. The treasure was empty. It was found by him. What happened in the treasury? There was no treasury. There are so many reasons for the empty of the treasury of the country. Particularly, before him, 14th Louis, he interested wars. He spent huge amount on wars with foreign countries, and he expense on to build a buildings. Number of buildings. In this way, treasure was maximum decreased. After him, 15th Louis came to the throne. He enjoyed the life with luxuries. In this way, he expends more and more amount on his luxuries. These are the main causes. Another cause is French helped to the American colonies. in the independence 1774. Particularly, American colonies wanted to freedom from Britain. So they struggle against Britain to get independence for their country. In this way, France helped that 13 colonies against the Britain. These are the main reasons for the treasury was empty. In this case, after 16th Louis came to the power, he found this problem and he wanted to increase its taxes. Mr. 16th Louis, look at this picture, observe the Louis 16th and his wife. He 16th Louis ruled from 1774 to 1792. He came to the throne at the age of 19 years old. He married in the early years. Look at that next picture, Marie Antoinette. She was Austrian princess. She married Louis XVI in the 8 years old. Actually, Louis XVI is personally had good name, but inefficient person to administrate the country, a state. Particularly, Marie Antoinette is unpopular among the people because of she always oftenly interfere in politics. After came to the Louis 16th throne, he wanted to impose new taxes. So he wanted to in this case he called for meeting for to impose taxes. First, we look at this picture. The French society was. What is the French society? What is the society? The French society was divided into three classes, which were called estates. So, French society was called estates. There are three estates: first estate general, second estate general, third estate. These are the main three categories of the people are there. In the first estate general, particularly clergymen, look at that picture. First estate clergymen. Who are clergymen? Clergymen means priests and church officials. In those days, Christianity more popular, so maximum most of the people followed Christianity. That's why most of the people Christianity was taken. So clergymen belongs to first estate general. Second estate, who are nobility? Nobility, who are nobles and landlords. These are belongs to second estate general. Third estate, common people, a big businessman, merchant, court officials, lawyers, teachers, etc., peasants and artisans, craftsmen, small peasants, landless laborers and servants. These three estates, first and second estates, only 5% of the total population, but they had huge landed estates and wealth. And both the first and second estate general had special privileges. They lived luxurious life and neglected their duties. Third estate gender, remaining people. Look at the picture. Privileges. What are the privileges enjoyed the first and second estate gender people? The peasants were about 90% of the total population of France. Total population, 90% of the population belongs to farmers. About 60% of the land was owned by the church and other rich members of the third estate gender. 60% of the lands under control by the church officials and other third estate members, rich people only. The clergy and aristocracy enjoyed certain privileges. Peasants. Look at this slide. Taxes will be imposed by the churches and feudals, landlords, and state. Peasants were only paid the taxes to the state, church, and feudal lords. Look at this, and also peasants' services to give the state. That means they worked in king's palace, and they worked their fields, and they worked road buildings. In this way, they have lot of servicing given to the state. Taxes were also paid by them only. The first and second estates did not pay any taxes, but they were enjoyed with special privileges and rights. What are the taxes peasants were paid? Look at this. Church was levied tax, that name is tithe. And the state was imposed tax, that is daily. This is the direct tax. This tax should be paid directly to the state, that is daily. And tithe should be paid by the peasants to the church officials. Not only these taxes, and also other taxes were also imposed by the country, that means state and church, feudal lords. Particularly, they were levied taxes on consumption articles we are using every day, such as salt, tobacco, and other articles. Look at that point. The third estate alone had to pay taxes to finance the activities of the state. Failure of crops. Not only general situation taxes were paid, and also particularly crops were failed. In that situation, peasants were paid to the taxes to the state, churches, and feudal lords. This is the situation in the France. In this way, a growing middle class and end to privileges. Middle class. What is the middle class? It is a new social group emerged in the French society, who were earned wealth through overseas trade and manufacturing goods such as woolen and silk textiles. Middle class people were also well educated. and well efficiency in trade. But they had no any social privileges like first and second states. Then they wanted to get these rights, and also they demanded right to voting. Merchants and manufacturers, lawyers and administrative officials were also belongs to middle class group. This group is very efficient and wealthy people. This middle class people were influenced by the Renaissance. In Renaissance, there are middle class people were followed the some writings of the philosophers, particularly John Locke, Rousseau, Montesquieu. Look at these pictures: John Locke, Rousseau, and Montesquieu. Look at these pictures: John Locke, Rousseau, Montesquieu. These are the main philosophers from the French society. What is the role of the philosophers? First, society, they wanted to create based on the rights, freedom, and equal for before law and opportunities for all. This was done by all the philosophers: John Locke, Rousseau, Montesquieu. John Locke wrote a number of books. From one book he is writing, that is Two Treatises of Government. This writing against the belief of that the monarch had absolute rights. That means he said that only the absolute rights belongs to the monarch. That is not correct. Rights are rights have all are eligible for that. Another philosopher is Rousseau. Social contract. He proposed that government should be based on a social contract between the people and representatives. Government should be formed the agreement. What is the agreement? Social agreement between them, which is people and representatives. People elected their representatives to form the government only. That is the social contract agreement wrote by the Rousseau. Another one is the spirit of the laws. He proposed that powers should be decentralized. But always powers should be centralized to the king and other officials, kings. But he proposed powers should be decentralized among the institutions, constitutional institutions. What are the constitutional institutions in the France? They are legislature, executive, and the judiciary. These are the constitutional institutions get the powers. This type of principles followed after French Revolution, particularly the American colonies. American Constitution was followed these principles. decentralization of the powers. The outbreak of the revolution. On May 5th, 1789, Louis XVI called for a meeting. He Estates General to pass proposals for new taxes. Particularly, he wanted to make new taxes. What are the taxes we have discussed already? In this session started on May 5th, 1789, from First Estate sent 300 members means representatives to this session. Second Estate of was also sent 300 representatives to the session. Third Estate was also sent 600 representatives to the meeting. First and Second Estates seated side by side each other, but Third Estate representatives were stand back them. Next slide, there is a picture. You can understand how they respect in the assembly. Look at this next point. Peasants, artisans and women were not allowed to enter the assembly. This is very bad reason. Particularly peasants, artisans and women were not allowed to the meeting. Only the educated people were eligible for the meeting. That is from the Third Estate. But their demands laid down on the note papers, particularly letters. Their demands laid down on the letters. 40,000 of letters sent with them. Voting system means there are three estates in the Estate General. First Estate, one vote. Second Estate, one vote. Third Estate, one vote. Every estate has a vote only. But as per the estates only, not for the members. This practice followed every king in the French throne. The same practice continued now also Louis XVI. In this case, Third Estate member representatives were not accept this practice. Why? Because they demanded every representative has a vote, should be provided, not estate for a vote, member for a vote, they demanded. But Louis XVI not accepted for their demands. Look at this picture. The Estate General session was started. This is the First Estate representatives. These are Second Estate representatives. The rest of the people, these are standing back them. These representatives are belongs to Third Estate General. But there is a problem in voting system. Old practice, Louis XVI wanted to same practice in the olden days, but Third Estate representatives were not accepted and boycott this meeting and went out near the grounds of the indoor stadium, that is tennis court, indoor stadium of Versailles. Look at this. After went out this meeting, the representatives of the third estate felt that they were representing the whole French nation. Look at this. We are the representatives for the French, not first and second estate representatives. Why? Because they were felt that in the France, total population of the nation, 95% of the people belongs to third estate, not first. Only 5% of the people first and second estate people. So they announced, they declared, we are the representatives of the nation. They pledged the oath, that is known as the tennis court oath. It was done in the grounds of tennis court, so it is called tennis court oath. This was led by the three leaders, Mirabeau, Abysses, and Bailly. The three leaders led this movement. While the National Assembly was busy drafting a constitution at Versailles. Actually, these third estate general, when they were declared, we are the representatives of the nation, they wanted to make new drafting constitution of the nation. Until that, they don't want anything. This is the one side of the France. Another thing is there, France. First, you will look at the tennis court, oath, this picture. Observe all the representatives, their hands raised and started their pledge. What are they wanted? They wanted new drafting constitution. This is one side of the France. Other side of the France, what happened? Look at these some conditions, situations. What are the situations in the France, rest of the France? There was rising chaos and disturbances in the rest of the France. What are the chaos and disturbances? All over the country, there is a number of problems are there, particularly food scarcity. Food scarcity is the main problem in the country. In this way, they started strikes, hartals, protests, different types of violent activities are also done by the people. The crops had ruined because of extreme winter. That is a winter season. So crops were failed. The extreme cold. The price of bread went up. Their daily heated food, that is bread. Bread prices were raised more and more. And some of the bread makers, they are called bakers. These bakers misused this situation and accumulated supplies of bread. Accumulated means they store the food grains. Food grains means bread. They hide it. Already, the people waited for hours in long queues at the bakers, particularly women. They are waiting to get the bread. Waited for hours, but there is no store. There is no availability of a bread. The very angered people went to the Bastille port. It is the Bastille jail. who are struggle against the king, they were suppressed and arrested and sent to the jail. That jail is the Bastille. That is the Bastille port. All are these people went to the Bastille port and broke out at. Look at this picture. First, look at this. This is troops. When the people were started struggles against the king, then king was sent to the troops to suppress the any revolts in the country. In this way, the people were angered and go to the Bastille port prisoners jail and broke out. The storm of the Bastille port, it was recorded in the history on 14th July 1789. Look at this picture. Look at this. These are the revolutionary people broke out the Bastille jail, then released the all the prisoners of the people, third estate people in the jail only. In this, look at this one thing. Every year they can celebrate National Day of France, July 14th. After the storm of the Bastille port, they were celebrated. After the August 1789, the assembly passed a law to the feudal system of taxes and other obligations. There were made number of laws passed by the assembly. That laws, according to that laws, banned feudal arts, special privileges. First and second estates privileges were banned by the laws. Tithes were banned and lands were owned by the church were taken back from them. Tithe is a tax. It was levied by the church. Who were not paid the tax, their lands were occupied by the church officials. That lands taken from them. Now, this is the lesson. After this storm of the Bastille port and all the privileges were banned, taxes were banned by the assembly laws, then they were celebrated 1789. Look at this picture. They were celebrated every year their national day on July 14th. Remaining class, we will discuss day after tomorrow.